is Tony Lewis.
Big occasion, the end of season, one-day final. Warwickshire versus Worcestershire, very much the local derby, but there's no place quite like Lords. And for Warwickshire, it's been an outstanding year. In fact, they haven't looked back since they won here 12 months ago.
It's in the air, and it's safe. And Warwickshire have won a famous victory here at Lords.
Of course, Warwickshire have been here before and to play Worcestershire, when they won the Benston Hedges Cup final. Well, they've also won the county championship, and unbelievably, it could be 4 out of 4, a grand slam of titles achieved for the first time ever. A lot of it's to do with this man, Brian Lara, great one-getter, all around the world, broken records, but it seems for Warwickshire, gets runs only when they are really needed.
We didn't realise that he would score so many and break other records besides Sir Garfield Sobers' test record, the world record of 501 against Durham, but he scored 2,000 runs. He's equaled Alvin Kalicharan's record of 9 centuries in a season, but he's given us those runs so quickly, which has given us time to bowl the opposition out. And of course, he's raised the standard of every other player. They realise they are playing with the best batsman in the world.
Everything's gone almost perfectly for Warwickshire. Dennis Amos, the secretary up there, Bob Woolmer, the coach. Great enthusiasm amongst all the members. But for Worcestershire, let's think about them for a moment. Well, it's revenge time, isn't it? They've got to get back. They came here and lost. And truly, they have something to prove today. Let's take a look at the teams. Well, for Warwickshire, hard to pinpoint the stars. Outside Brian Lara, that is. But everyone has really risen to Lara's presence within the side. And everyone has performed to the top of his ability. And Worcestershire, well, they'll be looking for runs from Hick and Moody. That really will be the platform for their progress. They have a useful seam attack, with Richard Illingworth in there to bowl the slower stuff, left arm. The toss was won by Worcestershire. Tim Curtis won that, no hesitation, put Warwickshire into bat. Let's join that innings now in the second over. The score is 4 for no wicket, and Newport bowls to Ostler.
Very good shot by Ostler, got well on top of the ball, bent the front knee, and with no great flourish at all, it just shows what timing can do.
Well, he rehearsed it the ball before, but then far more controlled way. Not a half volley, ball on the up. It's no more really than a forward push. Beautifully timed. Lovely straight bat. Just a check follow through, and that sped away through extra cover for 4.
In the air, caught him. Another full length to waist swinger, drawing Dominic Ostler forward into the stroke. And the swing took it away in the air to backward point.
Dominic Ostler, shade tentative. Very full length. Phil Newport and Ostler just steering it to lamp it in the gully. It was really, after that glorious extra cover drive the ball before, presented with another half volley, a long half volley, and all he did was tentatively push at it and steer it very gently into the gully. A late movement from Newport, bowling to a very full length, but it was a half volley. Be disappointed.
Yes.
didn't quite get out there and over it, but Paul Newport now realises that there is some genuine swing in the air for him. He's always been a tricky sort of bowler. His action very much looks as if he's slanting the ball in. Swings away. Well, this is the left-hander who's been sent to test him. A man by the name of Brian Lara. One more look at that, and you see. Just a couple of steps to the right taken by Lampitt, but it was a straightforward catch, and the early wicket falls. In the second over, in fact, 8, a loss of 1 wicket, and Dominic Ostler goes. It occurs to me that Dominic Ostler might be rather too free-scoring a batsman, and his style too free, and a little bit loose for the new ball attack in a one-day final at 10:30 in the morning. You need a lot of technique, reasonable amount of caution, and Dominic loves to go for his shots. But he is a man who likes to play a few shots.
Well, he loves scoring at about a run a ball, scoring at that rate in the county championship, which is a phenomenal rate of scoring. Not had quite as successful a time in the one-day competitions for Warwickshire. Loves the big stage, though. And there is no finer stage or bigger occasion in domestic English cricket than this.
Yes, what you can detect, even from a distance, is that he gets runs when they're needed in the big matches.
Only a small man, Brian Lara. Hits the ball phenomenally hard. And just a pointer for the viewers. Just look the way he picks the bat up, his back lift, the flourish with which he brandishes the bat.
Well, there's a big shout there. Did he flick that down the next side? And it's called a wide. Well, that's rather an anti-climax for Worcestershire.
Well, one thing's for sure, you can't be caught off a wide. But a huge appeal there. Impossible to tell from that whether Brian Lara touched it, but it certainly was well wide down the leg side. I think he missed it by well, comfortably anyway.
Another big shout for LBW this time. Not out, says Nigel Plews, but Warwickshire definitely on top of their game out there. And very few better bowlers in the country when the ball's swinging and moving off the seam than Philip Newport.
A very confident shout. Superb start from Phil Newport. Used to play and miss from Brian Lara. Flickers a leg side wide, and then a very confident LBW shout that was going down. 1 for 7. Well, Brian Lara's faced 4 deliveries. He's not managed to get a bat on any of them. Played and missed at 3 and hit on the pads with 1. Give you an indication of what's happening out there. Tom Moody, just 2 singles coming from his first 2 overs.
Beautifully bowled.
So Jaffa. Absolute superb delivery. Need a barn door to hit that. Pitch middle and off, missed off stump comfortably.
Ah, Mr. Dickie Bird has always claimed to have had the ear of the Prime Minister. What a scramble behind there.
The ball's going sideways here for Phil Newport. That's set off way down leg side. Certainly carried through to first slip. I just wonder whether it hit the outside of the pad or the bat. Just coming off the outside edge of Andy Mole's bat. Stephen Rhodes diving across, and I think that obscured D'Oliveira's view of that. Beautifully bowled. Turned him inside out.
So the last four overs have been made, and there's Worcestershire winning the toss, sending Warwickshire into bat.
Andy Mole's preparing himself. Next delivery. Mouth open. I'm not quite sure which page of the coaching manual that's on. Blinking.
Well, that's why he does it. So that when it's pitched up and away swinger, just wide of the off stump but slightly overpitched, it means you're ready for to stroke it for four.
Well, that was better, wasn't it? A bit more authority in the shot. Width from Phil Newport. Beautifully placed by Andy Mole's.
And then every other ball pitches, leaves you.
Well, as a batsman, you just can't do anything about that. There's no way you're going to get an edge to it. Movement is just too much. You shrug your shoulders, get your head down and wait for the next delivery. And as a bowler, of course, you've just got to keep plugging away, putting the ball in that same spot time after time. Don't try and bowl magic deliveries, pitching leg hitting off. Keep it in off stump.
That's good bowling by Philip Newport. Just that one wide of the off stump, but even then, Andy Mole's played the ball a long way from the body. Certain amount of risk involved. You can hear the subdued gossip of anticipation around the ground. The old enemies, Warwickshire, Worcestershire, the local derby. And also these were the finalists of the Benson Hedges Cup earlier in the summer, when Warwickshire won quite comprehensively, but then they fielded first.
Giving that the full treatment, but he missed it, and it was a comfortable wide. Well, swung himself off his feet.
Oh, that's a big shout. He was on the move, but the ball struck that front pad very early.
Well, that looked really, really close to me. Pitched in line, hit him just below the knee roll. That's probably just missing off stump, I think, in umpire Shepherd's opinion.
That's a very graceful stop on the fine leg boundary. Normally when players take a dive for the ball, it's a bit of a rough and tumble, but this is graceful slide. Out he goes. Almost inevitable, really. Animo's played some brave strokes, but they were isolated ones. And all the time he knew that one ball would come, which wouldn't move quite so much, but just enough to catch the edge of the bat. Rhodes took the catch. Newport the bowler. Out for 8, 17 for 2.
Well, it was just a matter of time for Phil Newport. Kept pulling the ball. in that area. Andy Moles lunging at that. I suppose you could say that he didn't have to play at it. He was drawn into the shot. It's the faintest of edges through to Stephen Rhodes. Just a thin nick. Stephen Rhodes makes up his earlier misdemeanour, diving in front of Damien D'Oliveira.
Paul Smith is the new batsman. And two slips come back in now as Paul Smith takes guard and prepares in this 10th over to fight off this attack.
It's quite cleverly bowled, a slow ball, and Lara was well through the shot.
Itching to get off the mark, Brian Lara. Doubt whether he's been marooned on naught for this long ever in his career. Into the pull. Bottom edge into his pad.
Just a little desperate. Big zero still on the scoreboard. But no longer. That's relieved applause from all the Warwickshire supporters. 35 minutes, 26 balls. Might be just what's needed. Everyone's very tentative out there. There's a few shudders and playing and missing. No one seems to be able to get on top of it. Perhaps Paul Smith's the man. Mark Nicholas has joined me in the commentary box. Morning, Mark.
Morning, Richie. And Paul Smith, not shy of attack. It's the best method of defence in this tricky situation that's developed in awkward conditions this morning.
Well run. Picked his man, Neil Radford.
There's a fair bit of tension between the two sides anyway. Strong Midlands rivals of many years, unarguably the two best one-day cricket teams in the country. And of course the small matter of the Benson Hedges Cup final at the beginning of July, which Worcester strongly felt was totally dependent on the toss.
Good calling and running from Brian Lara.
Lara actually came from a magical 190 against Hampshire earlier in the week. And Paul Smith was also playing against Hampshire, but in a second 11 game at Portsmouth. So he's gone from the sublime, from the ridiculous. And Lara may be the other way.
Just short. Richard Illingworth had the chance there with an all-out dive. Must have been coming more slowly than he expected. Actually went to earth well before he needed to. A few hearts and mouths around the ground. That'll be Lara's. Having a good morning, Philip Newport. I remember him playing against Australia up at Headingley in 1989, and on that occasion he couldn't miss the middle of the bat. Now today he can't even find the edge. Just a bit wrong-footed, Neil Radford, at mid-off. An awkward bounce. For a moment, he would have thought it might have carried to him. And Paul Smith once again has carried the attack to the bowler.
That's a super stroke. I mean, he's just taking the bowler mid-off and mid-on out of the game by looking to hit it over the top of them. Very strong. Hits very cleanly. And terrific attitude, but tricky time to come in, and it needs a lot of guts to play the way that Paul Smith's looking to, and he's not short of guts.
Great shot. Now that's a lovely touch of Lara.
Brian Lara has one objective when he goes to the crease, and that is that he likes to bat for an hour. He believes that if he can stay in for an hour, it's then his fault if he gets himself out. He's been in for some 45 minutes. He's had a long look at it, and the beautiful thing to watch there was the footwork right back on his stumps and so quick to pick up the length of the ball.
Paul Smith again. Run the first one fast and then turn quickly and gone through the second. Philip Newport is being rested now. He's had a very, very good spell from the nursery end. Neil Radford's going to come on now. Tim Curtis is the man in the foreground, the skipper of Worcestershire. Wonderful flat throwing arm. And down at deep fine leg, that's Tom Moody. 180 in the semi-final in that brilliant match where Surrey Orbit got up. A good cricketer, Moody. May well force his way into the Australian side to play against England. The coming Ashes battle. For Neil Radford, that's quite a tidy average and good wicket haul. A lovely square drive. It's been a wonderful morning for this match, with tension early on and the bowlers on top, and then suddenly a little bit of a glimmer for the batting side.
Brian Lara opening the face and choosing to pick the gap through square cover rather than hitting the ball straighter. Neil Radford, a full of a length bowler.
Things work just 50 up. It's a good effort to get there in the 19th over, considering that the second wicket went for 17 in the 10th. A lot of credit that is for the new batsman, Paul Smith. Fourth successive final in which his batting has made an impact. Doesn't look an orthodox batsman. Back in 89, when Warwickshire beat Middlesex, he came in, scored of around 50 for four. He got 23 at a runner ball and re-established the innings, and then last year's 60 in that mammoth 320 odd against Sussex,
42 not out this year against Worcestershire. And again, the first one to come in and really put bat to ball. Makes such a difference, Mark, when you've got a player like that who's not prepared to compromise whatever the match situation or the conditions.
Yes, very much reflects the general enthusiasm and confidence that surrounds Warwickshire's cricket this summer. They've not let themselves get stuck in holes, rather they've dug their way out of it by aggression, believing offence to be the best form of defence, and they've done it most effectively.
That might be the end of it, though, and it is. Well, one blow too many. End of Paul Smith. Warwickshire now back in trouble again. 50 for three, and we're only in the 20th, caught by Gavin Haynes.
I think you set me up, Jack. Paul Smith committed to the front foot, and the ball banged in just short of a length and probably not really there for the pull. I think Paul Smith will look back and think that he let that enthusiasm I was talking about get the better of him. But not a wasted innings by any means. Some momentum to Warwickshire's performance. And they don't now have to play with desperation. They can look after Lara, so to speak, who can play his own game. And of all of the small scores, the 13s made in NatWest finals, this has had great merit to it.
Gavin Haynes, the catcher. He's having a good season with Worcestershire.
Yeah, I think you can see from Paul Smith's feet.
Roger Tu is the new batsman, and already this year he's shared in 400 partnerships or more, two of over 200 with Lara. Of all the young Warwickshire players who've derived benefit from the coming of Brian Lara, Roger Tu's has been number one. Batted up and down the order, opening in the championship. One of the strengths of this Warwickshire side is that they can rejig a batting order. The shot of a man in form. One away, couldn't find the gap. Tom Moody's final over. It's been a wonderful spell. Just look at that.
And he'll be smiling with quite the same ease if he got a little edge to it. Real beauty from Tom Moody. Bounce and movement that we were talking about. As I say, he's just half a yard quicker than you think. He jars the bottom hand, and that's, well, it's gone like a big off break.
And another one. Two's not happy, but he knows there's nothing he can do. If he gets one of those, his day if he misses them. Final ball of Moody's spell. On the spot, and what a hand he'll get for that. Well, I don't think, Mark, you could ask for anything better than that as a captain.
No, fantastic performance. Just the one loose-ish ball pulled away by Brian Lara, and nothing else that could be considered indifferent even. No half volleys, very little down the leg side, terrific lines and bounce. Made life very, very difficult in just the sort of conditions that Gladstone Small and Tim Munton used so well in the Benson Hedges Cup final. Tom Moody has come back with the perfect riposte and used them beautifully himself this morning.
Neil Radford. Wonderful shot. It's the power as much as anything else. It's capable of opening or closing the face in mid-stroke. What's the face of the bat open there? It's crashed away square. Look at it from this angle, and a lot is said about the placement. You see, that wasn't all that wide, but it was hit with immense power.
He plays the ball so late. It's a fine example there. Exasperated shout from Neil Radford and Stephen Rhodes as he plucked it off his pad. Down to fine leg for a couple. Sign of a truly class player, the lateness with which he plays that. See the keeper and the bowler, arms aloft. Even so, on this pitch, is affording help to all the bowlers. Still got to be pinpoint accuracy when you're bowling to Lara. Can't give him any width at all.
Remember him playing here in the Championship against Middlesex, and he got 100 in the second innings. That was his sixth in seven. I spoke to Mike Gatting afterwards, and Mike had watched him from slip, and the thing that impressed him was his late adjustment to the swinging and seaming ball. He said once most batsmen get something from the quicker bowlers that moves, then normally they're committed, and that's that, but not Lara. He said his standing still and quick reflexes and eyesight are such that he could adjust to stuff that motor batsmen couldn't.
Stuart Lampitt, been around for a while. He's bowling round the wicket. First time we've seen somebody round the wicket this morning.
Oh! Well, not a bat loosener.
Superb line as well, straight away, over the top of off stump.
Just normally a loosener. Just look at the extravagant movement and how close it was to the line of stumps. It was on them, but just the bounce that took it past. We'll go for two.
Roger Two's on strike. Said by his captain Dermot Reeve to be the batsman who's learnt most from playing in the same side and batting with Brian Lara this season at Warwickshire.
Wouldn't seem much better than that at all, because such a strong player, mostly on the side, but can play that side of the wicket as well.
That's a beautifully controlled shot from Roger Twos. Not much follow through, but beautifully straight bat. Timing. No real effort in that.
From the stump camera, and it is, isn't it, Paul? I mean, the foot has been taken there, the shoulders led into it, all the weight into the shot, and nicely timed.
It's that type of width ball that gets wickets in one day cricket.
Kevin McDonald and Bob Willis. And either they were talking to or listening to Dickie Bird. Left forefinger for giving them out.
It's been quite a pleasant morning so far, but just a few more clouds coming in now. So
little restive touch about the crowd. A few spots of rain falling, which is please anyone at all.
And that's not going to please Neil Radford.
Not a happy man, Neil Radford. Roger Tews chassising down the wicket, short arm pulling that over mid-wicket. Eye on the ball. Fine strike. One of the first bits of outward aggression that we've seen from the Warwickshire batsman this morning.
Well, that's a good shot. Quite premeditated.
I just think Neil Radford has lost a little bit of that nip over the last couple of years. And that's a perfect pickup shot by Roger Tews, clumped over mid-wicket. Perfectly safe from outside off stump. See how far he's got down the pitch. Fine aggressive batting.
His cricket must be very strong if Roger Tews can't get into either of the two touring teams chosen the other day. Although, I suppose England's loss might be New Zealand's gain. There's a rumour around that he may move out to New Zealand, could finish up playing against England.
Feeling that if Roger Tews hadn't played a shot at that, then Nigel Clews would have given that a wide. Right up in the block hole, good couple of feet wide of off stump.
Kevin Haynes is the man down at deep third man, end of Radford's over. And there are one or two umbrellas going up now. Temperature has suddenly dropped a little. That's not a good sight. The umpires will stay out there as long as they can, through as many overs as possible before lunch. And two more to Lara, and he's now moved on to 36. It's looking a little more gloomy than was the case about 45 minutes ago. And the rain has started just a little heavier now. Batsman coming off. Had a great morning's play. Tension and atmosphere around the ground. Full house when the first ball was bowled. Tough conditions for Warwickshire. They struggled through the first 12 overs. After 11 overs they had 18, after 12 overs 24, and really were hardly laying the bat on the ball.
At 12:25 the players left the field. The rain was just too hard for them, and this was the state of play at the time. 88 for 3, a hard day's batting there for Warwickshire, 29 overs of it, with Brian Lara fighting his way to 36 not out with support from Tews, 20. And the bowlers, they had a very good time of it. But I think on the whole, Worcestershire rather unlucky not to get more wickets, but excellent performance there by Tom Moody. 12 overs, 4 maidens, 1 for 17. And Phil Newport picking up 2 wickets for 23 off 7. So this is the state of play. Worcestershire 88 for 3, 29 overs bowled, and play resumes on BBC One at 10:30. But a frustrating time for all of us here,
very wet around the ground, and in the end, the enthusiasm of this partisan crowd, local derby, remember, Warwickshire and Worcestershire, it was really dampened by the conditions. So from us all at Lord's, it's good night.